What's up, everybody? It's Derek Lambert here. Check out the description, like, share, hit the bell, share this thing. It might help somebody who's heading down the wrong path. But I'm going to talk about alcohol and what it feels like to detox off of alcohol. I am an alcoholic. I seem to not know how to control that. But before we do, we have a Discord room. If you download the Discord app, it's free. The room's free. You guys come in and you can talk about this stuff. Alcohol, anything. If you're coming off whatever, it doesn't matter. We're here to talk. You know what I mean? So check us out. Let me take you guys back to what led up to me doing alcohol and going the path that I did. First off, I was a kid. My pops, you know, he's in the special forces, so he's military, and alcohol is like a hoorah. If you don't drink, you're not part of the crowd. You're not even considered part of the group if you're not a drinker. And they all drank, and he's an alcoholic. Of course, he found out over the years, as well as we did, what alcoholism is. Long story short, I was about 13, I believe, 12, 13 years old, and I had a couple beers. They were good, but the way that they made me feel, you know, I had a good feeling, but the tequila, when I had a couple shots of that, I felt invincible. I felt like Superman. And so it really made me feel like I had no more fear. I could overcome whatever. I really felt like I was bigger than I was, stronger than I was, faster than I was, more handsome, more confident, everything. It brought all the great elements and everything was amazing. The warm, fuzzy feeling of what you get. Music, you get certain feelings that come from it. And for those of you who, most of the world, if you will, has alcohol, they drink, but not all are alcoholic, right? So you can understand these similar feelings. And some people who do alcohol, they find themselves where they get sick and they're like, I'm not doing that again, but see, I'm different. I wanted more, I wanted more, I wanted more, and I kept drinking. Well, I would periodically throughout the years drink, and then I'd stop, and then I'd drink, and then I'd stop. And I finally hit a point in my journey where I had a lot of personal stuff going on in my life. And so drinking actually helped me escape. I felt like all those feelings would kind of go away, or at least it would numb them. But even then, those feelings and what was going on in my personal life, it would come out and I would cry while I was drunk or get angry when I was drunk and either hurt myself or hurt others. These are things that happened. Now, I had days when I would drink and I would feel the sharp pain in my liver. It would be painful. But I'll put it like this. It's not nearly as bad. My experience is not nearly as bad as someone like my father's has been or someone else that I've met in alcohol, you know, circles. The detox, first of all, you're shaking. You can't help the fact that you're shaking. But you're getting – I had cold sweats. And this is just from my experience. It's not just mine but other people's. I got cold sweats and I was cramping. I was so dehydrated that my entire body locked up. I literally locked up and was freaking out. I was panicking. I couldn't help but feel jittery. It was like – very hard to describe, but the pain was extreme, extreme, extreme. And this is why it's super recommended that you go to a hospital. Don't try to bear this out by yourself or on your own. A lot of people have died trying to detox off of alcohol. It's serious. It is extremely serious. So please get help on that. But after the detox, or if you will, after the first, I'd say 3 or 4 days, I still wanted to use and drink. And I only drank consistently for about, I'd say, a year. But it was every day, all the time, alcohol, alcohol, alcohol. So I was consuming a lot. Everything was about that. I can only imagine people who drink this for years, the difficulty and the tough, you know, situation that they're in. Once I got off of that, I had moved my family. All these personal problems I had, I was trying to make things work. Me and the wife had a lot going on in our personal house, and we were separated at this time. So I'm drinking, trying to numb the pain, and I decide I'm going to move my whole family to Washington State, and that'll help me escape this thing. I found myself blacking out drinking up there. I'd wake up from a blackout after being drunk and done things I never would have done to the family, you know? And that's the level at which this alcohol had me, where I couldn't control the fact that I couldn't control doing it, especially after I started consuming it, I couldn't stop consuming more. I wanted to keep drinking and keep experiencing that, chasing that high from the alcohol. But also, when I was sober, all I could think about is wanting a drink. So there's like, all I can think about is wanting to drink. And then when I drink, I can't stop thinking about wanting more to drink. It's the same mindset that you have when you're using drugs or whatever. This is why when you're doing like a 12-step program, I don't care what the label is. It's just about principles and helping you get your life together. Because your life's unmanageable at this point. And that's what happened to me. So detoxing off alcohol, go to the hospital. I really recommend it. It is extremely painful. If you have never felt that pain or never experienced it, don't. But I'm telling you, it is not to play around with. Benzos and alcohol are like the two you don't want to play around with because people can actually die. Not saying you couldn't die from other stuff withdrawn, but statistically speaking, it's easier to die from those two than it is alcohol or from you know, like opioids or even uppers of any sort, that kind of stuff. Detoxing off of that is not nearly as dangerous as the alcohol and the benzos from my research. I'm not a medical professional. I'm telling you purely my experience. I could delve into many stories about alcohol that I've had on blacking out. You know, it was a social thing. But I would have never, and this rabbit trails into the marijuana scene, I would have never smoked pot if I wasn't drunk, personally. I was raised that it's for losers and, you know, we're high speed. Only top-notch jock, you know, studs drink and we don't smoke pot. Smoking pot's for losers. But little did I realize, you know, how all this stuff fits together. I learned a lot. And today I just want to let you know I'm not encouraging drinking or anything like that. I'm just telling you my experience. It is highly recommended, I would say, to stay clear if you have a problem like I do. And if you do, get some help. I mean, we've got the Discord group, and then I would see a doctor for sure. They know what to do and help you in this process. Anyways, I'm going to make more series on different variety of drugs. Let me know if you have any questions in particular pertaining to alcohol or any other substances that you want me to talk about. Up and coming, I will be talking about my experience of my sex drive or hormone levels on opiates, heroin, and I can even deal with that topic in a broad spectrum of discussing when it comes to any substance. So it varies. It varies depending on what I was doing, what my sex drive was like. So that being said, I hope you guys are having a good night, and this is Alcohol with Derek Lambert. Until next time, check the description out.